Hello and good evening. My name is John. We're back with What Remains of Edith Finch. We learned about Barbara last episode and a couple other people, and we're gonna keep on looking. What the heck is that? Is that a pizza? It's a cake? Huh. Alright. Do we go out this way? No, it's sealed. Oh, wait. Yeah, we wanna go this way. And then...
I guess now I know why Mom didn't like me playing with the music box. Whenever people ask me about my family, the first thing they always want to know about is Barbara.
Barbara, Barbara, Barbara. Okay. You're not really landing on the stairs, but I give you half credit. Just like in the comic book.
Mom said the basement was off limits, unless I wanted another tetanus shot.
Big basement.
I saw Edie sneak down to the basement once, carrying packages. I thought maybe she was hiding presents. It turned out she was hiding a lot more than that.
A little prepper here?
I remember asking Mom once about where Walter had gone. She said after Barbara died, he got as far away as he could. If there's a pattern in all these stories, I think it's that none of us has gotten very far.
Walter. All right. All right, let's read Walter's little book here. 2005.
Goodbye, everyone. I can't believe I've been down here for 30 years. On that first day, after the shaking started, I didn't think I'd survive a week. But after a few days, I settled into a routine. That's what kept me sane. Having a schedule, living for today. I always expected to be dead tomorrow. But if you wait long enough, you get used to anything. Even a monster on the other side of the door starts to feel normal. Almost friendly.
Great text placement.
And then one day, everything just stopped.
No shaking.
Whatever that thing was, it was gone. Maybe it got tired of waiting. Or maybe I just got tired of being afraid.
Oh, so many peaches.
It's been a week now. The longest in 30 years. I'm done waiting. I have to leave while I still can.
Can Can't leave that way. I want to leave, I want to go deeper? Alright. Jiggly Farm, it's a good name.
I know it's out there, somewhere. Whatever killed Barbara and Molly and Calvin. Maybe this is all a mistake. But I need to stop living the same day, even if it kills me.
Nice. Nice done. Nicely done with the font treatment there.
Whatever's out there, I want you to know, I'm ready for it.
Is
I'm
it
going
a train?
To appreciate all of it, especially the food. I don't mind if I only have a year left. Or a month. Or a single week. I'd be happy with one more day. I can already imagine the sun on my face.
Walter died when I was 6. I can't believe my mom never told me he was down here.
That's super weird.
I'm sure my mom was trying to protect me. Maybe she was afraid I'd end up like Walter. But if she never told me about an uncle under the house...
Albino's super crispy.
I can only imagine what else she was hiding.
This trash pile has got
to stay. I don't want to make the same mistakes she made. Trying to bury something that's still alive. Now that there's only one of us left, or maybe two, I thought it was time I heard the stories for myself.
Maybe two, foreshadowing.
And found out what happened to everyone else. But now I'm worried the stories themselves might be the problem. Maybe we believed so much in a family curse, we made it real.
Nice island they got.
I don't know if I should even be riding this. Maybe it'd be better if all this just died with me. But I thought you should know about your family. And the history you're a part of.
Edith, are you pregnant?
Though to be honest, I feel as lost as you probably do right now. I think the people in these stories believed them, for what that's worth. Look at the house. That history of imagination and stubbornness and madness. Any of it seems possible.
which way? No? Alright.
I think we've been surrounded by death for so long, we've just gotten used to it. What kind of family finishes building a cemetery before starting the house? It's embarrassing for me to admit this, but the pet cemetery may be more uncomfortable than the human one.
Shadow, Christopher, Oliver, Bob.
Three of the gerbils are mine, and two had been my fault.
Bailey. That one's knocked over. Zerpy, Zoe, Coco, Lurpy, Burpy, Chirpy, Burpy, Derpy, Derpy Jr. Lucy, Daisy, Charlie, and Tucker.
Sven built the house, but it was Edie who designed the cemetery.
Aw, Molly, Calvin, Steven, Edie. Wait, that's in quotes. Walter.
I'm sure Odin's monument had been Edie's idea. My mom was always trying to move on, but for Edie, the past never went away. She could see it poking out of the water at low tide. Edie said she dreamed about the old house every night. Edie's side was always easier for me to understand. But the older I get, the more I can see where my mom was coming from. Her dad had been pretty strict, but it wasn't enough to save her brothers. She was just trying to do better.
Sam, Gus, and Gregory. They were in the military, they said?
She lost two of her brothers, just like I did. I get why she tried so hard to protect us.
Who's Finch? Sanjay Kumar. And that's not a Finch.
We never found Milton's body, so my mom insisted we were putting up a monument, not a tombstone. There's so many things I wish I could ask my mom now. Part of me thinks this is what she wanted all along. For me to come back someday and find everything out for myself. But looking back on it now, if she told me there was going to be so much climbing, I never would have come when I was 22 weeks pregnant.
Aha! It's like five and a half months?
I never met Grandpa Sam, but I think he and my mom had a lot in common. They were both pretty intense. Sam spent his life shooting photos, but Mom said he got nervous being in front of the camera. I guess we're all afraid of something.
Dawn, I promise, you'll never forget this weekend.
Yes, sir.
These memories are going to last a lifetime.
Am I going to have to shoot anything?
It's a hunting trip, Dawn. Shooting is strongly encouraged.
Shouldn't we be leaving?
Just want to get a shot of you, Don, then we can take off. Perfect.
It's gonna rain the whole weekend, isn't it? I will never forget this weekend, Dad.
That's the spirit.
Okay, got it.
I'm gonna take some pictures, okay?
Just be careful. A camera's older than you are. Hey!
That's a keeper.
Definitely should not have drunk all that coffee.
I'm just saying, I'm not always gonna be here, Don. You'll need to remember this stuff, if you want to survive.
I'll be fine, Dad.
You know who else?
Dad!
Good eyes, Don. Before you take the shot, let me get a picture of you.
Dad.
Let me get behind you.
Do I have to do this?
Don, you don't have to do anything. But if you want to survive, you'll need to be strong. Great shot, Don!
Oof.
I'm proud of you, Don. Always remember that, okay? Sorry, Don. Just gotta reset the timer.
Dad, it's twitching. I think
that's totally normal, Don. Just focus on the camera. Try not to think about
it. Dad!
Wow.
Of all these stories, that's the one I wish most that my mom had told me. Instead of hiding from death, Sam seemed to go out of his way to meet it.
Airline ticket for Kay Finch. This asbestos can't be too good for you.
After Sam died, my mom and Edie got really close. They'd both lost a lot.
Oof.
Dear Kay, do you remember the way Gregory used to laugh when he thought he was alone? Like something funny was happening, but only he could see it. I think he saw things the rest of us don't.
Froggy!
That's hand over, Gregory. It's time to... Hold on, sweetie.
Oh, no.
Hello? Sam, I told you I don't want to talk right now.
I wonder what he saw. What his world was like.
Thank you.
lost in his imagination.
I must get all the letters.
Whatever it was, he saw. I worried about a baby being too happy. But I could feel him slipping away.
Sorry about that, Gregory.
I know you did everything you could.
I was worried there for a moment.
Maybe if I hadn't called that night.
I'm worried again.
There's so much I don't understand about Gregory. About everything. But I know what happened wasn't your fault. Sam.
Oh, that's a downer.
I can't imagine my mom ever writing poetry, and yet...
A poem for Gus, who always said the wedding was a bad idea. Our father never hit us kids, at least not very hard, before the day my brother said with teenage disregard that he'd be dead before he'd see a wedding in our yard. My father made him come, of course, but Gus stood far apart, just flew his kite and bottled up the storm inside his heart. I tried to talk him out of it, but though he'd never met her, we don't need a stepmom, were the words that
I now pronounce you husband and wife. You may kiss the bride.
When the time for photos came, Dad ordered him to
come here.
But Gus declined, and as a sign, held up his middle finger.
Oh,
disappeared and quickly went. But all the humans did that day was go inside the tent.
I'm gonna get lightning struck. Oh, there it is.
The rain came down in buckets then, but no one seemed afraid that nature might destroy the tent our dad had crudely made. The thunder sounded much too close and full of angry power. But all my father said to this was, "Make the music louder."
A little Katamari Damacy going on there.
I wish that I could truly say I thought about you on that day. Out there on the beach alone, just you, the wind, the sea, and foam. But I didn't. Until we found you. She never talked about him, but Mom told me once if I was a boy, they were going to name me Gus.
Oof. Wow, your house has to be big if you have emergency evacuation stuff. And a rock climbing wall.
My mom moved up to the loft after her brothers died. At the time, it was as far away as she could get. Religion was another thing my mom never talked about, but I think it helped her a lot after her dad died. She spent a summer building houses in Calcutta, where she met my dad, Sanjay.
I think I need to go back up. It's fun to go down the pole, though.
My mom moved to India a week after graduation and got a job teaching English. Lewis was born a year later. When my dad died, I don't think Mom knew where else to go. I'm sure Edie was happy to have her back. And to see kids in the house again. The house had to get a little bigger, but Edie was used to that. And for a while, things were good. Almost normal.
Alright, homeschool.
But it didn't last. Milton's 10th birthday, when Edie gave him a castle.
after Milton disappeared, the only thing he left behind was a room full of paintings.
And sculptures.
Milton Finch in The Magic Paintbrush.
Inception.
I was 4 when Milton disappeared.
I'm missing.
Mom spent months searching for my brother.
Some of the.
And she sealed the doors.
Some of the family members so far.
Whatever Milton had found in the house, Mom didn't want it getting out.
Oh, so fit to go up.
Mom definitely blamed Edie, but I think Lewis blamed himself. After he graduated, he just spent more and more time in his room. Until Mom got him a job at the cannery. Everyone always told me to stay out of Lewis's room. Except Lewis.
Is this an airplane? A boat? Great view there, Lewis.
Lewis's room smelled very, very familiar. That part of him lived on.
Dear Mrs. Finch, as Lewis's psychiatrist, I can understand your desire for an explanation. As I see it, the trouble began in January. Shortly after we convinced your son to seek treatment for substance abuse. Newly sober, I believe Lewis first noticed the monotony of his daily life. He kept working at the cannery. But he withdrew part of himself. In our sessions, I saw the same behavior. His mind began to... wander. I asked him to describe it. He said he started small, imagining a labyrinth. He'd feel his way about. Then something moved. Bats. And toads. Things that have not names. He knew it was all in his head. But he took it very seriously. I had hoped he'd find himself. But he found something more. worried about him then. Daydreaming at the cannery. I spoke with his boss. But he said Lewis had become a model employee. Methodical, tireless, focused. Like a whole new Lewis. So I let him go on. I even encouraged him.
This can't end well.
It seemed very promising at first. He told me he'd made a new friend. On the edge of a city he named Lewis Topia. He built the city up slowly, brick by brick. Then he made musicians. Songs for them to play. He talked about starting a band. And he was always humming something. Every day his imagination grew stronger. He no longer spoke at the cannery. But his chopping was as reliable as ever. Then one day it struck him. At all the cheering crowds, even the stones under his feet, were all in his imagination, so he could do whatever he wished. He held an election for mayor.
And he won.
And he won. They begged him to stay, but his mind was already wandering. It became a game for him. He'd conquer a city, then immediately push on. New Lewisville. St. Louis.
All right, St. Louis is an obvious one.
He started drifting away from our reality. Minneapolis.
All right,
until one day he forgot to go home from the cannery. Even as his mother pleaded with him, part of Lewis kept sailing off. In Lewisburg, he heard rumors of a beautiful prince. The prince was on his own quest for radiant rainbows.
Well, it's hard to steer.
He followed the sound of his...
Oh, hell yeah.
Electric sitar. His chase led him to a golden palace east of the sun and west of the moon.
I'm just so anxious now, knowing that this choppy thing is here.
Even then, his logic remained sound. He knew the world was all in his imagination. But he was so proud of having created it. In his own eyes, he'd become something greater than a king. For someone who'd never known success in the real world, I think it was overwhelming. And then it struck him that the real Lewis was not the one chopping salmon, but the one climbing the steps of a golden palace. My imagination is as real as my body, he told me. It was hard to argue with him. Began to forget the world we know. I think it pained him to remember Lewis, the cannery worker. He began to despise the man with a royal contempt. I still thought I could save him. Even after he said he was being crowned king over all the lands of wonder. The palace would be packed with his companions.
And a cat.
Including the wise Calico, who'd insisted on inviting him.
Is it Molly?
His prince waited, holding his crown. There's only one thing left to do. Bend down his head. And the rest I think you know. Mrs. Finch, your son was a kind man who will be missed by all of us who knew him.
My brother was really cool. I wish you could have met him.
Oh. Okay. As cool as that sequence was, I need a bit of a break, so we'll probably be back for at least one more episode after this. Cheers!